So this beautiful piece of meat, I'm going to cook it over the weekend. So I'm marinating it right now. It's called dry rub. That like aging the steak. That way the meat can have all the delicious flavor. And on this side, I'm gonna put some, open this oil for me, Anaya, please. Move in the bone and pour some oil on this. This is a red pepper oil, so it's kind of a little spicy. So I rub this on the meat, and I'm going to place it back in the freezer. I'm gonna do on both sides. Still frozen. And then I'm ready to cook it. All those flavors, even though it's frozen, they're still gonna get inside the meat. Especially as it's thawing. So it's gonna be well seasoned instead of just thawing. Like it's gonna, instead of like, you know, like, how you say it? So have lots of great flavor. Chef Anaya is helping me here.
I think I see blood.
Is this blood? Yeah, because it's fresh. This is called a cowboy ribeye. All this marbling makes the meat very juicy and flavorful. So just like that, and then I'm going to wrap it back in there. And this was like 27.70 at Sam's Club. So this is some good meat. A little bit more oil, yes, on that side. We didn't put any oil. And the oil helps the marinade to kind of stick on the meat.
My hand is frozen.
Yeah, it's so cold. All right, so now we can close it and then put it in the freezer. And I'm gonna put it in a Ziploc bag to make sure it's nice and secure. All right, guys, so here's the ribeye. It's a cowboy ribeye, and I've marinated this about 3 days ago, and it's to extract moisture from it and makes it really flavorful because it's a big cut of meat. If you try to marinate it the same day, it may not come out. You may not be able to reach like deep in there. And I'm gonna add a little bit of salt. And you can see how the meat, it kind of looks different. It is fresh, but because we marinated, we released some moisture and put up the seasoning inside. So here in my cast iron, I have some olive oil. It's probably not hot enough, but I'm just gonna, that's good. Place it right there to cook. And I'm gonna try to find something to add some weight to it so that it can, this would have been really good on a grill, but I sold my grill when I was moving. And I'm gonna finish it in the oven. It's gonna be so tasty. So on that side, I'm gonna make sure I add some salt as well. And just like that. So on this side, I'm gonna let it sear for about 5 minutes because I like my meat to have a nice sear, and it's a big cut of meat. So 5 minutes should be good on each side. And I'm going to also turn it on this side
to melt the fat. Because there's a lot of flavor in those marbles. We call it marbling. And it has a lot of great flavor. That's why I added just a little bit of olive oil, because I know it's going to produce its own oil.
Yeah.
It's gonna be so good.
Okay,
and when you have steak, when you have steak bone in, the bone adds a lot of flavor to it. So the juiciness of the bone and all that adds, it's very rich in flavor. Flip it to the other side and put some butter, because the butter is just gonna melt into it and gives it a nice flavor as well. Then I'm going to wrap the bone with aluminum foil, because if I put this in the oven just like that, it's gonna burn the bone. And I love the bone. I love it. I love to suck it and all that stuff. So it's really flavorful. And you can even make a beef stock with it. Not after you suck it, of course. But if you don't like to enjoy it and get all the juiciness, all the bone marrow. See how rich it is in bone marrow? So you can always make the stock with it. Now I have it flipped on this side where it had a lot of fat, because I like it to be cooked, well cooked as well. And this butter is giving us a brown butter flavor, which is delicious. All right, so this is pretty much done with the searing. Now I'm going to put it in the oven. And like I said, I'm going to put some aluminum foil on this so that it doesn't burn when it's in the oven. Just like that. And I poured some of the brown butter in this. Oh yeah. Delicious. Look at this beauty. So beautiful. Look at perfection. So I'm gonna let it rest before I cut it. Beautiful. Pour some of that juiciness in it. It's all the butter and the fat from the meat. Sometimes you can add rosemary and some thyme. I have some rosemary in the garden, so I'm gonna put some on this. Enhances flavor, lots of flavor. Beautifully cooked. And then now you can see, I'm going to remove the foil, otherwise it wouldn't have been burned. So, this is beautiful. See that? That's how you do this. That's how you do it. Beautiful. Alright guys, look at this beauty. Taste this piece. It has some of the marble, some of the fat, which is when it's cooked, it just feels so good. It tastes so delicious. This is very hot. Look at it. This is cooked to perfection. Beautiful.
Oh my gosh. The flavor is just amazing. Right, Anaya?
Yeah.
She had a little piece there. So I want to let it rest. I don't want to cut too much of it. That way I don't lose all the juiciness. Look at this baby.